And the breaking news that I promised I'm going to bring you right now, it's China's first response after the Ladakh standoff began 23 days ago. China's ambassador to India, Sun Weidong, has struck a very conciliatory note and said that we pose no threat to each other. Ambassador Weidong has further added that we need to consolidate our ties. And this comes right after China's own foreign office just a couple of hours ago has said that its stance on the border issues with India is consistent and clear, and that the situation is overall stable and controllable and can be resolved through existing border talk mechanisms. So two big conciliatory or softening notes that have been struck by China right before Trump has offered to mediate. I'm not linking the two. I'm just saying that today, almost in unison from the foreign office to the Chinese ambassador in India, there has been a conciliatory note that appears to have been struck. Gaurav, coming to you first, forgive me, but I'm a bit of a China cynic. I don't really believe in words. I believe in actions. And China is still mobilizing in a very big way in Ladakh. China has been known to play psychological mind games, strike a conciliatory note while mobilizing with the military. Before that, before I go to Gaurav, let's play out for you what the ambassador of China has said.
Federation of Young Leaders, CYL, for organizing this online event during the epidemic. I would like to say first that the virus makes us keep social distancing, but it can never keep us apart in heart.
Gaurav, what are you making, of these two big conciliatory messages from China? Possibly the most reasonable, peaceful sounding messages from China, Foreign Office and the Chinese ambassador. All respect to the ambassador, but China is known to play mind games, say one thing and do another.
Shiv, we've suffered at the hands of China's sweet talk and hard action on ground right from the 1950s. Remember Chao Enlai saying Hindi Chini Bhai Bhai, and then the invasion. That's point one. Point two, even after the Wuhan summit and after Mahabalipuram, if we see a brigade strength of Chinese inside or very close to our territory or at the line of control, actual control, it's a cause for grave concern. Why should that happen in the first place? An occasional patrol can come in, but not a brigade. That's point two. Point three, if there is a Wuhan summit and if spirit, and if there is the Chennai connect, why should this happen? So instead of sweet words, what is very important to be seen, whether we see the Chinese troops move back, the engagement at both at Pengongso and at Galvan River was rather unfortunate, especially when the Chinese, according to some reports, were resorting to using sticks studded with nails. That is not how neighbors behave, especially when they say that social distancing can come in terms of COVID-19, but not hearts. If China wants to win hearts,
yes,
then this action at the LAC needs to stop, Shiv.
Absolutely. Saying one thing and doing another is a famous Chinese tactic. Nevertheless, a conciliatory note twice over sounded by the Chinese system today. Geeta, how is the Indian government viewing this? There hasn't been an official response, but how is the Indian Foreign Office and the Indian system viewing this soft message, if you will, from China today?
Well, no official reaction, but again, Shiv, they understand China's play. Mm. This is again not the first time, like Gaurav said. They've been doing it repeatedly, even during Doklam. We had very strong voices coming from Beijing, and then the ambassador over here, Ambassador Luo, who was striking a very cordial note in his interactions and his briefings, clearly goes to show that they're trying to play the whole tactic of good cop, bad cop. Doesn't help, because India understands China, the Wuhan spirit, the informal summits that India has been so heavily invested in, and so was in many ways the One China, really has not reaped the benefits that you'd like to see. Why? Because we've seen a more difficult situation now than ever. And the Indian side has come out in a very strong statement. The Ministry of External Affairs had said, Shiv, that activities are taking place on our part, our side, if at all any. And if at all there are any violations, they are only being carried out by the Chinese. So China will have to, again, like you said, Shiv, China will have to know that only saying things does not help. You have to weigh your words and then back it with action.
Absolutely. So the onus is now on China to back its words with some action. Stop the mobilization, stop the aggression, stop the escalation. It's not India's initiative. It has to be China's. India will continue to stand its ground, as we reported to you in that full inside track on how the Modi government is dealing with this situation.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.